I'm usually your worst nightmare when you see me walk into a room and I'm asking for a sputum. And that's exactly what we're going to talk about right now. Okay, so does this look familiar to everybody? Yeah. Okay, so this right here is a mail-in, and I was asked to kind of talk about it before we get started. So I just want to make sure that everybody recognizes when we have the start or 3 days into an exacerbation, and what we should do and what we would like you to do is recognize those symptoms. So whenever we feel like we're, our shortness of breath has increased, and this is within a 48-hour period, we have an increased mucus production, our, you know, just the irritation in our airways, maybe we're more fatigued, we start noticing that our appetite is gone, then that's when you should probably get a hold of your physician and see about getting a sputum sample in as soon as you can. Has anybody ever used these or, okay. We do have these available on the second floor, on Two Goodman, if you'd like to have some handy, so just in case, because we like to get the sputum samples in as soon as we can so we can start culturing and see what's going on. Okay, but definitely get a hold of your physicians when you start experiencing those symptoms. So we'll put that right there. The topic of my talk is the what can I do to feel better, and throughout this whole conference and all the speeches and all the everything that we've spoken of, it's airway clearance. And so I have put together just some tools that are out there that are available for you. And I know that we have quite a few here that are have already been educated on airway clearance and aerobicas and vest therapies and everything above, but there are some that maybe have questions or maybe have not been exposed to those therapies. So I'm gonna go ahead and show you some, and if you have any questions, we can catch those at the end. Let me see if I do this right. Okay, so the first thing I need to do is, I'd like to just talk about this disclaimer just for a moment. I'm currently working outside of National Jewish for Hillrom in Electromed and Respirtech. And this it's not just a job to me. National Jewish has, it's kind of a catapult to what I'm doing right here with these three companies. Before it was going out and meeting people in their, or patients in their homes and setting them up on vest therapies. But it's really gotten to be kind of a passion of mine because I go to patients' homes when I'm asked if I can set them up with a device. And it surprises me that when I do get there, that a lot of these patients, they don't have a clue about the bronchiectasis. They know that they got a vest or it was prescribed. And myself, I feel like if you're not educated on what's going on with you or your health or why you're being given a vest, then it just doesn't make sense. So it's gotten to a point where when I do go to patient homes and I take them their vest and sit down with them, I talk about what's going on and what their concerns are and what their fears are and to let them know this is why you need this and this is why your doctor prescribed it and the benefits of it. So, and now that's with the vest companies, all three of them. So I enjoy it. I enjoy it. So we're going to talk about the bronchiectasis as we have been all day long, and what we can do to help with clearing out our airways. Foundation for therapy, or what we're looking for, is patients that are diagnosed with the NTM, cystic fibrosis, asthma, any mucus-producing respiratory diagnoses where we need to get in there, clean those airways out, start making you feel better, less time in the hospitals, you know, decrease any risk of infections. So that's what this is all about. So the goal of treatments, again, is to just go in there and just clear out those secretions, decrease any obstruction in the airways, improve our ventilation. We feel so much better when we start clearing out those airways and we're able to take deeper breaths and just, again, improve quality of life. You can start doing things. You can take longer walks. You can walk up those stairs a little bit further. So everything is a positive when you start concentrating on the tools that are available for you. And why do we need it? The normal function of airway, or the movement in your airways, is that cilia. And I believe we were shown the actual movement of the cilia in the airways and how it moved mucus back and forth and helped to bring out and mobilize some of those secretions and some of the particulates that we breathe in. When that cilia is moving back and forth, it's actually mobilizing the mucus in the large airways, central airways, where it can be expectorated or coughed out a lot easier. When you have compromised airways, for whatever reason, we have a dysfunction of the cilia, and again, it is that mucus impaction, if we have a lot of scarring, whatever the case may be, if we don't have movement in those airways, then we can't get that mucus out. And then we have that real huge risk of infections and other damage to the airways. As far as the infections, overproduction of sticky mucus, and that ineffective cough. We definitely need to work on our coughs. I've worked with quite a few, and it's that huff cough, if anybody has ever, if you have ever heard about it, or you need to practice it, but we're here as respiratory therapists to show you how it's done. Airway clearance is a non-invasive form of therapy. It's there. There's lots of tools. There's lots of techniques to help clear the mucus away from those walls, get it to the central area of the airway so that we can cough up that mucus a lot easier. There's a lot of different therapies out there that can be prescribed that will make it a lot easier. Sometimes we just kind of, we know it's there, we cough, it doesn't want to come up, we get ourselves dizzy, we feel like we're going to pass out. There's so many therapies out there that are available, and so you can just ask your physician or your respiratory therapist and we'll be more than happy to show you. Methods used for the airway clearance. There's quite a few. I listed just a small portion of them, but it would be your oscillating the positive expiratory pressure, which basically is your aerobica. There's the acapella out there. There's lots of devices out there that may be handed to you. If you're ever in the hospital for whatever reason and you're handed an airway clearance device, an OPAP device, and acapella or aerobica are the ones that I generally see come back around to us where we have to reinstruct. But you're given a tool in the hospital. They're telling you to go ahead and just make sure you use this every day. Let's get this mucus moving. This is going to make you feel better. And then you're on your own. So you're home trying to figure out how to use this, and it generally gets put in a drawer. So please just know that there are certain techniques to use with the OPAP device that's going to help clear the mucus. It's not a tool that's just handheld. It actually works, and if it's operated properly, then you'll definitely be able to feel the difference. So please get a hold of your respiratory therapist or anyone that would have the knowledge of the tools and ask them how to use it. Okay. Your high-frequency chest wall oscillation is your best therapy, and if you guys, you probably saw the equipment that I have sitting outside this door. There are lots of different products out there. They all work equally well. There's pros and there's cons with each one, but that's the same with any kind of equipment. If it's set properly, if you're using it as prescribed, then it's going to work. But you need to make sure that your pressures are good, your frequencies, your time on it, everything needs to be set properly in order for you to benefit from the use of the vest. CPT, so you can also use this It's just a manual CPT. I'm sure everybody's probably had someone near and dear to them kind of pound on their backs and try to move mucus around. In postural positioning, laying in different positions. Obviously, we don't like the Trendelenburg very much, but there are certain positions that you can use. You can use that in conjunction with your aerobica or your acapella, if that's the case. You can use that in different positions, and that seems to work well also. I also included the cilia and the mucus, and basically what we've all been hearing today and explanation, and that the cilia is those fine hairs that move along in those airways to help mobilize the mucus. And if your cilia stops working, the mucus that we're producing pretty much every day is just kind of sitting there and not moving out of those airways, where it just kind of sits in those small little pockets. And then, okay, now we're heading the other direction, where we have that really high risk of getting infections. So we want to get on this as soon as we can, get the stuff out, and start making you feel better. So I just listed a few of the, as far as what we look for, as far as the production of mucus, and obviously we have different types that we look at. We always have patients that tell us that we have the worst job around, because we're always holding up our little cups to the light and saying, oh no, this is a really good sample, you know. But and so that's what we look for. We do induce sputums. That is preferred with everybody here at National Jewish, is induced. So we really want to make sure that we get down into those airways and get a really good sample. So I thought this was kind of a cute little picture, and this is one way, as simple as 1, 2, 3. So the first thing we want to do is we want to unstick all that mucus. So we're going to be using OPEP devices. We're going to be using a lot of high-frequency vests and so forth. Once you do your huff cough, some patients or some individuals may not understand that when we describe a huff cough and they've never heard of it, I look at that huff cough as being so important, because you need to get that huff and you need to get the technique down in order to get it pushed up through those small airways into the larger airways. That's where it's easiest to get it, to bring it out when you cough, to expectorate it. So the huff cough is really important in getting that technique down just right. So in your books that you got, I have listed here, if you're curious about how do I do a huff cough, basically it's a forced expiration. You're kind of just pushing up, and I'm just going to do this and kind of hold my head this way. But whenever we teach a patient how to do a huff cough, you can generally hear just like that. You're pushing it up. You're keeping the glottis open. You want to push it from the bases upwards to your larger airway, and then cough it out. So huff comes before a cough, and that's definitely going to help you clear those airways out. There's different devices out there. A lot of flutter devices. You're going to find some good, you're going to find some bad. You're going to find, you know, some individuals or reps that are telling you that this works better than the other. My thing, and this is straight across the board, we look at products that are really going to open up those airways, something that's going to create that positive pressure within the airways, the nice percussion down in the airways. And also what's really important is we got mucus down in those pockets that we're trying to get out. You got to make sure that your equipment is kept clean. That's just huge to us. So if your equipment is not clean daily, if it's not sterilized weekly, then you're just, that's a risk. It's a creation of risk of infections. And we definitely, the reason why we're moving the mucus out of our airways is so we can avoid this. So cleaning and sterilization is huge when you have any type of equipment. We did hand out the aerobica for years here at National Jewish, and as everybody who has been coming here for years knows, that almost every year there's something always changes up, and that's what this this conference is. It just, we love it because when through the year, if we come up with something new or something better or something that's going to help the patients, then we can share it with everybody. And that's what happened with the aerobica. We used the acapella for a while and then we switched over to the aerobica. One of the reasons, not only do we feel that the material and of the product is sturdy enough to where we can really clean on a daily basis, as we could sterilize with high heat, so we know that it does get clean. It opens up into four pieces, whereas the acapella, you can't. There is one out there, the acapella choice, that breaks down into four pieces, but we find that the product, the aerobica that we use here at National Jewish, is a good product just for that fact. It not only works well, but you can definitely clean and sterilize well. So with the aerobica is, I just have a picture here that shows the airway clips. We in the past have used the PARI products. I'm pretty sure everybody's familiar with the PARI Sprint or the PARI Plus that we handed out for years. So we just kind of changed up. We have the airway clips nebulizer cup. One of the things with the PARIs that we found is it's a good product. Don't take this the wrong way. It's a very good product, but the Aero Eclipse, we found it does create a smaller particle size. So we do know that whatever medication that we're taking, primarily our antibiotics, they're getting down to the size where we know they're getting deep into those airways. Also, the Aero Eclipse can be used with all your medications as far as albuterols. You can use it with your salines. You can also use it with your antibiotics, and those have been case studies, so we know that. Otherwise, we wouldn't switch. We wouldn't, we just wouldn't go out there and put a product out that we weren't comfortable with. But that being said, the AeroE clips can attach nice and easy to the back part of that aerobica. Hypertonic saline is another way that we could thin mucus out and bring it up those airways a lot easier. You can attach the Aero Eclipse to the back of the aerobica using albuterols and salines. And then, of course, you have your compressors. And pretty much your standard compressors, they're gonna be okay if you're doing your salines or your albuterols. There's not a problem as far as the high PSI. When we're dealing with antibiotics, we definitely want to have a nice, powerful compressor, and just by research we have found that the Ombra compressor or the vials, if you already have that, they produce a high PSI, which is a high pressure, in order to help break down that medication as far as the antibiotics go. So just please pay attention to your equipment as far as your nebulizer cups that you're using for your antibiotics, and it's the right one, and you do have a good compressor that's going to help create that fine mist. So I just listed a few other things that are definitely out there as far as the G5 percussor, the electric percussor. There's your manual handheld that you can also use or have somebody else use. We've had patients just use it on themselves. Oh, sorry about that. And then you also have, you can have somebody doing handheld percussion in different positions also. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm just going to show you just a few of the high-frequency vests that are out there and just kind of talk about them just briefly. So we have the Hillrom vest. The Hillrom has been out there for quite a while. It's a great product. And any one of these devices that if you're interested, just ask your provider and they can talk you through it. Usually we try to do the aerobica first to see if that's, with minimal airway disease. The aerobica works very well. Once you start getting into an area where we feel like you need a more aggressive, We do have the machines that work really good. The Hillrom is out there available. Also, the Encourage device. Each one of these devices do create a high percussion or hertz or frequency. You can do adjusted pressures so that we know that we have a good contact, and a 20 to 30 minute therapy twice a day is usually recommended. And there's a smart vest is also out there. This one doesn't have buckles like the other two have. The Hillrom has buckles, the Encourage has buckles, the smart vest has Velcro. So some patients may prefer a Velcro if they have arthritis and it's hard to operate that, then that's out there available for you also. There are two different types of portable vests. The Hillrom does provide the Monarch. This has just been in play, I believe, probably about a year that they've just had it. So it is battery operated. So if you're interested in any type of portability, and we have a lot of patients who, you know, are interested, but just check with your physician and make sure that it's the right device for you. Some machines are more aggressive than others, and given what's going on, that might be a question you want to ask before you go into purchasing it's costly, is what I'm saying. So the Aflo vest is also out there. So it's the Aflo, the Monarch, or the two portables. So you actually have five units out there that are available to you if that's what you're looking, or your provider is feeling is going to benefit you. So this is my last slide. Basically, the benefits of pulmonary hygiene are to just basically, we're going to be moving mucus or secretions out of those airways, decrease recurrent lung infections, antibiotic use, hospitalization, and you'll definitely notice a decrease in cough, because right now, with lots of secretions or mucus within those airways, and our body just naturally, we're just coughing to try to get it out. Once we start clearing out those airways and we just have that normal production, then you will notice that decrease. Improve your gas exchange and improve quality of life. And that's basically what we want, is to improve quality of life and get you back to doing things that you're used to doing before. So thank you.